plants that burn. Let's do that. Okay, so let's get this out of here.
Ah. Watch out.
This is when it'd be really nice. So we've covered some of these. It'd be really nice to be untethered. But here's two that are, let's go flammable, and then we'll go non-flammable. Does that sound okay? So what to look for. And you'll see on this side, things that go up in flames very quickly, they mainly have needles. Not all of them, some of them don't. But this is on the courthouse, the statehood tree, the biggest tree out front, the one they light up with all the lights in front of the courthouse on the left, that's this tree. It's probably 50, 60 feet tall. It's magnificent, huge, big swooping branches, fast growing, classic Arizona blue, and it is a matchstick. It just goes up. The flames are so big, it'll be impressive. But probably don't put this next to your house. Put it out by the driveway, by the street, at the back corner. Put it back there where it's isolated, and then create that island around that and enjoy it. And if the firefighters, if they come in, they see this is a high risk, that you're going to try to save your house, probably take a chainsaw and just cut this down, drop it to the ground, and try to keep things low. They're trying to keep it out of the canopy. Once it's in the canopy, it's all over. This, Spruce Mountain, actually doesn't have any spruce on it. It has white fir, or conicolor fir, it's native fir, and Douglas fir. It has firs. This grows wild on the ridgelines around us. Big tree. Huge trunk, soft needles. It's like the teddy bear of all the conifers, just soft. Whereas spruce has real stiff, pokey needles. This is much softer. So it looks innocent. As soon as you put it in the ground, Douglas fir turns into this huge swooping, I think they're hardier than Deodar cedars, these other things. I think this is a better plant and native. Once you get it rooted and started, you can take it off of all care. But I would water it once a month, April, May, and June, to keep it hydrated during the hottest parts of the month. Once the monsoons come, I wouldn't water it again. I say, the rains will take care of it and be fine. So Douglas fir goes up in flames. This one I use a lot because I'm using shredded bark in my own yard. So I've got lots of real dark mocha kind of colors. When you plant this out by the pond or out by the across the way where the dry creek bed is. This is tough as nails, but it's kind of a rock star. This is golden juniper. It just looks bright. If you got real dark mocha rocks and stuff, this is a bright spot. It's almost like you turn the switch on and it goes, oh, look at me. And it doesn't sun scald and do some of the other things that some of your yellow plants do. I love the color gold in just the right space. I think it looks funny when you're planting gold with like crushed granite. You got gold yard, crushed granite, but gold plant, they look like they need an iron fix. They need to be fertilized differently. If you've got a dark rock or dark backdrop, you put these in, they look magnificent. Great design technique. But I would not put this up next to my house. I wouldn't put it by the patio. I wouldn't have it anywhere within 30, 50 feet of my house. I wouldn't have this close. I'd have it out there, not in here. Okay. So this is down past my, got a huge entertainment area in the back, big sweeping negative edged patios that overlook the dells and towards the peaks. So my patio is a huge defensible space. Nothing's going to burn on that. So I've got probably 20, 30 feet of patio the entire length of the house. Hot tubs and grills, and it's just pretty. You want to entertain there.
Coming to your house.
So I plant past that away from the house, and it's pretty. So we're overlooking from the decks and the patio these kind of brightly colored, flammable plants, but they're so drought hardy. I don't have to water it. It's a great plant for you if you use it strategically. Okay? Any pines? This is a single leaf petal. Which one is this? Pinulus. Two needle pinion pine. It's related to our native pinion pine. This is the one they get the pine nuts off of. So if you go into Whole Foods or whatever, this is where the nuts came off of this. And I find this tree is hardier for scale, some of the disease things that we get. This doesn't get that like our native one does. I think it's got a little bit fleshier needle. I think it's just a better plant to go with. But don't plant it next to your house. This will go up. I could probably take a Bic lighter and get this to go up right now. Beth, I should do that. Next time when I'll bring my lighter, we'll see which ones burn and which ones don't. That could be an interesting experiment. I probably want to test that first, see how truly dangerous it is. I don't know.
Do it the day you have a fireman speaker.